Hello students, in this session we are discussing oscilloscope, next topic of unit 4, and this is lecture number 4. So oscilloscopes we commonly called as CRO, cathode ray oscilloscope. So let us see the details of the cathode ray oscilloscope. As we are also well familiar that CRO is a measuring instrument. So it has a display, and on that display we can observe different types of waveform, and with the help of waveform we can measure different parameters of that waveform. For example, we can measure the frequency of that waveform, and we can measure the voltage peak to peak or peak voltage of that waveform. So this is the laboratory CRO. Look, you can see that in this CRO, this is the example of dual trace CRO, very popular dual trace CRO. So what is dual trace and single trace CRO? The single trace CRO has only one channel, so we can connect only one input to that CRO, that is called single trace CRO. But nowadays all the CROs are dual trace CRO, means at a time we can apply input to this particular channel A and input to this particular channel B. Channel B, channel A, sometimes called channel X, channel Y. So this is called dual trace CRO. So for this channel A, this is the control for that. This is the volt per division control, and for channel 2, this is the volt per division control. So some knobs are common. This is the screen of CRO. On this screen we can see the waveform. So these are the common knobs. The upper side knobs are also common, and this particular part is divided, so this side and left side. So we are well familiar with the front panel and front control of the CRO. So what is the purpose of CRO? So how the waveforms displayed on CRO screen? For example, this is the CRO screen. In that screen, scale is provided. Using that scale, we can measure the parameters. So there is a horizontal and vertical lines, equal lines. So x-axis is generally time axis, and y-axis for CRO is voltage axis, and z-axis is intensity or brightness axis. So this is about the axis of the CRO. So this type of information is available on the CRO: time and voltage, frequency and phase, DC and AC components, spectral analysis, rise and fall times, mathematical analysis also we can perform. So this is one example. We can also connect some sensor output to the CRO for the analysis. For example, this is photocell. So it detects the light intensity, and depending on the light intensity, the output is generated, that is voltage, and that voltage we can also measure on the oscilloscope. So same diagram is mentioned here. So you can see that there are two waveforms at a time. So we can also shift the waveform to the upper side or lower side. And there is an internal or external triggering available. So there is a vertical and horizontal system. So horizontal system is mainly time based, or time per division, that particular knob available in the horizontal system. Time per division means we can change the period of the waveform. That particular knob is called as time per division knob. The time per division knob, this is time per division knob. This time per division knob is changing the period of the waveform, that comes under horizontal system. And in vertical system, the volt per division knob comes. That knobs control the volt per divisions. It means amplitude of the waveform. So now there are two types of CRO, analog CRO and digital CRO. So dual trace CRO, that comes in analog category also and in digital category also. In digital category we call them digital storage CRO, and in analog category we simply call dual trace CRO. So this is CRO, this is external signal. So in between external signal and screen of the CRO there is no conversion, so there is a direct connection to the CRT. But you can see in the DSO, from the input side to the display there is a conversion. So there is a conversion using analog to digital converter. So this is very simple block diagram of analog CRO. So this is dual trace CRO. So you can see that. So some of the blocks are amplifier, delay line, trigger. So this is for single trace, not dual trace. Delay line, vertical amplifier. So now there are two sections. So this particular delay line, vertical amplifiers, this section is vertical section, and this trigger and horizontal amplifier, this is horizontal section. So this is vertical section, this is horizontal section, and then there is a display. Now we can see more detailed diagram of the CRO. So this is more detailed diagram of the dual trace CRO. You can see in this block diagram there are two separate channels mentioned. Channel A, so input 1, channel B, input 2, or sometimes input X, input Y. So this input is, for example, any unknown sine wave is connected here and some unknown triangular wave is connected here. So two inputs are applied from the function generator. Function generator 1 applied sine wave, function generator 2 applied triangular wave to this B channel. So internally the first block is pre-amplifier and attenuator. This is simplified diagram. Pre-amplifier, if amplification required, then it amplifies it. If attenuation is required, then it attenuates it. The similar function happens to the channel B also. Then after that, the output of both the channel is given to the important block called as delay line. This delay line is the block that provides delay to the input signal. This also provides delay to the input signal. This provides delay to A, this provides delay to B. So delay is required in the vertical side, because the signal is coming here, it is given to delay line. From delay line to this vertical amplifier, this section is called as vertical section, that I have mentioned earlier, vertical section. These two things are vertical sections, come in vertical section, delay line plus vertical amplifier, and this trigger and horizontal amplifier comes in horizontal section. Vertical section is responsible for the amplitude change, and horizontal section is responsible for the period change, the period of the waveform or time period of the waveform. So this is vertical section and this is horizontal section, you can see. Now after this delay line, there is an electronic switch. This is internal automatic electronic switch that continuously at fast, very fast, rapid rate, it changes to delay line A and delay line B. So our naked eye that cannot differentiate the change. So it is at this switch moves very fast or very rapid, so that the change is not observed on the screen of the CRO. So which channel, both the waveforms we can see at a time displayed on the CRO, but actually one waveform is appear first and then second appear first, but the speed of switching is so fast that we can get two waveforms appeared at the same time. That difference we cannot see on by our naked eye. After this, waveforms are given to the vertical amplifier. This vertical amplifier gives output to vertical deflection plates. So this is simplified diagram of CRT, cathode ray tube. Cathode ray tube, it look like this. You can see here the cathode ray tube. The output of this vertical amplifier, so upper output of this vertical amplifier is given to the upper vertical deflection plate, and the lower output of this vertical amplifier is given to the lower vertical deflection plate. So these two vertical deflection plates in CRT, this is called CRT cathode ray tube. The deflection plates are inside of the CRT. So this is for channel A and these two plates are for channel B. So output of this second vertical amplifier is also given to deflection plates. And this is horizontal side. This is horizontal side. In horizontal side, you can see that again one switch is used. The same switch that I have mentioned here. The same type of switch is also here. That switch is also continuously switching from input A and input B. So that only one horizontal side is required. So sometimes it is on channel A, sometimes it is on channel B. So the first circuit is trigger circuit. It is trigger circuit alerts to the sweep generator that the input is available. So accordingly, sweep generator generates the sweep type of signal, RAM type of signal. And that right RAM type of signal is given to horizontal amplifier. Horizontal amplifier provides that signal to horizontal deflection plates. So these two plates are horizontal deflection plates. And these two plates are vertical deflection plates. They are clearly mentioned here. You can see that horizontal amplifier provides signal to horizontal deflection plates. Vertical deflection plates are responsible to move the waveform vertically on the screen of the CRT. Here is the screen of the CRT. And horizontal amplifier is responsible to move the waveform horizontally. Here the detail part of CRT is not mentioned. There is an electron gun that emits the electron and that is accelerated through very high voltage, very high negative voltage through these deflection plates, and then that waveform is appeared on the screen of the CRO. So this is about cathode ray oscilloscope. In cathode ray oscilloscope, two signals are applied to preamplifier and attenuator. If it is required to amplify, it is amplified. If it is required to attenuate, it is attenuated. Then it is given to delay line. Delay line is the block that provides some delay in micro or nanoseconds. Because what happens in this, there are three circuits. After this delay line, there is only one circuit. But in trigger side, there are two circuits: sweep generator and horizontal amplifier. So to appear the waveform on the horizontally on the screen, this side requires more time than this, so that to match the time of vertical side and horizontal side, so that some delay is provided here, so that at the same time this signal is also given to the horizontal plane and these two signals are also given to the vertical plates. So that delay line is very important part. So this is about dual trace CRO. In next session, we will discuss digital storage oscilloscope, DSO. So we will revise it again. This is front panel. This is the front actual diagram of CRO. There are two channels, channel 1, channel B. There are controls, volt per division for channel 1, volt per division for channel 2. Time per division is common. So x axis is time axis, y axis is voltage axis, and z axis is intensity or brightness control axis. So we can also connect any sensor output to the CRO also. And this is about analog CRO. Simply we can call dual trace CRO. And this is digital CRO. We can call it dual trace CRO. CRO is also sometimes called power scope. So power scope that mentioned in syllabus is nothing but cathode ray oscilloscope. So this is very simplified diagram. Either we can prepare this one or this is the main diagram. So this diagram is at least expected from this discussion. Thank you.